guys, Dr. Christy Ennis. Today we are going to go over a head to toe, total body, quick stretching routine to help you improve your whole body flexibility and mobility. And just like Steve Carell asks, if you don't use it, is it true that you lose it? The answer with regards to flexibility and mobility is 100% yes. If you do not use it, then you will get tighter. Let's put it that way. Motion is lotion. So it is really important that you continue to work on getting mobility throughout the day to help us break out of this position. Hopefully it's not this bad, but we want to make sure we're getting that whole forward motion out of there, right? So this is quick, easy to do. Do it at work, do it at home. The lying down stuff, if you can't do that, you can always do it on the bed. Just keep that in mind too. Okay. Before we get started, I do want to give a quick thank you to my new Patreon members. Thank you so much for your support. Lane Hazelton, I can't read my own writing, Nancy Healy, Peter Sarah, Allison Parides, Scott Gray, and Rolly Osborne. And if I pronounced anybody's name incorrectly, please forgive me. I am sorry. But thank you again. So we're going to start up here with that head and neck. We're going to take that chin and we're going to bring it back. So goal is 3 to 5 repetitions of everything. We're gonna do 3 together, and that way you guys can follow right along. So don't go down, don't go up, but straight back. I had somebody call this the chicken. So you're gonna go back for 1, and just hold it for a second or 2. 2, and 3, good. From here, I'm gonna squeeze those shoulder blades together, open up those palms, that's 1, I'm going to turn to the side, bring that hand behind the back, and then tilt my head the opposite way. I face you again. Open, and then hand behind the other side. Good. So that was 1 on each side. Here's 2. If you cannot get that hand behind the back, it's okay to just keep it down also, okay? So squeeze and open, hand behind, tilt. And 1 more. Squeeze and open. Get out of this. Hand behind. Tilt that head. Dynamic stretches because you probably have been sitting and it's not good to just hold a muscle, okay? Bring those arms up as best as you can. It's okay if you need a little bend in those elbows. I'm going to clasp my fingers together except for that index and thumb. And we're going to go over to one side, over to the other. So 3 to each side. Starting to get into just the shoulders and the waist and the spine a little bit. Try not to rotate as you do this. 1 more. And I already lost count. Terrible counter. From here, you're going to rotate, open those arms. Try to look back as well if you can. Again, getting some flexibility for that neck. Bring those arms back up and then switch directions. Really open up nice and wide. So there's 1. You can add a little extension if that's starting to feel good too. Here's 2. Make sure that you breathe. It's the most important thing is breathe. Whether you breathe in on the motion or out on the motion, like I said, most important thing is just to actually breathe. Okay, bringing my arms down and bring your feet wide. Turn my right toes out. Left toes are gonna point parallel. Starting to get into the hips as well as that spine a little bit more. Left hand goes down that thigh. I'm going to bring that right arm up. Look up again if it feels okay on the neck. Keep that front leg bent. And then I'm reaching up. Okay, so there's 1. And this is 1 that if you were to walk in on me in the office, I'd probably be doing in between patients. Love, love, love this one. There's 2. 1 more, and then we're going to switch sides. And it's okay if you can't get all the way down, right? It's okay if you need to be up here. Nothing wrong with that. The goal is to feel good, not bad. All right, so switching directions. 1 foot that way, 1 foot this way. Here we go. Right hand comes down, left hand up. And I don't know if you could hear that, but that was a lovely snap in my hip, which felt fabulous. Here's 2. And again, really try to reach if you can. And yes, some of these are certainly yoga moves. For all you yogis out there, but it's a little combination of stuff, okay? All right, from there, we're going to keep those feet wide. Now we're going to turn them out at about a 45-degree angle. Bring my arms back up. I'm going to squeeze into those shoulders and come down into that little plie. So here's two and three. I'm going to stay in that plie now. Hands not directly on the joint, but on those thighs. We're going to do a little shoulder dip. Here we go. There's one on each side. I am snapping all over the place. And again, snapping is not necessarily bad. In fact, sometimes it's good. Don't let your knees collapse as you do this. And I'm going to come all the way back up, and we're going to end on the ground. Like I said, if you need to, please do this on the bed. You don't have to force yourself to get on the ground. But I'm going to take and I'm going to cross, so graceful, left leg over the right, arms out to the side, and now I'm going to drop to the right, and I'm going to turn my head to the left. You can always keep your head center if it doesn't feel good. And then we're going the other way. And the other way is just as important because now you're getting mobility actually in both hips, just in opposite directions. So we'll obviously do the other leg too. So there's two. Again, remember you can leave your head in the center. Try to keep those shoulder blades grounded also. And then I'm going to switch. Here we go, crossing that right leg over. I'm going to drop to the right first, turn my head to the left so I can look at all you lovely people, and then come back the other way. And you will notice, I'm sure if you are watching this right now, that I am absolutely tighter in one direction than another, and you guys will probably find that too. We got one more on each side. And now it's nap time. No, you should hopefully feel a little bit more energized after doing this. I'm going to show you one last option for that one, just in case it's difficult for you to lie down. You can do a little windshield wiper, hands pointed forward, feet wide, and then you're just going to kind of bring those legs back and forth. So now you're still getting a little external rotation and internal rotation of the hip. Okay, I'll just do a couple of those so you get the idea. But there you have it. A way to get that whole body loosened, improve that flexibility and mobility in a short amount of time. Thanks, guys.